Hey, horsey people, a couple quick videos. This one's of a girl getting on a horse. I mean, I can just tell by this horse how he's standing right now, he's not ready to be ridden. Of course, she has a purple halter or a purple rope, so purple is the new pink. And you know what? It's not important on what you know or how good your gear is or if it's proper gear. What's more important in the horse world is what color it is. That's the most important thing. So anyway, so that's my picking on women there, so people can complain about that. So she gets on this horse here. If you look at the horse's head, his ears, he looks tense. His head is very high. He doesn't have that flat top line I talk about when the horse is relaxed and he knows what's going to happen. This horse is telling me before she even gets on him that I don't know what's going on. I'm nervous. I got to keep my ears on you because I'm not sure what's going to happen. You don't want to do things with a horse when they don't know what's going to happen because it normally turns out not real good. So she gets on this horse. Notice the horse's head fake. He's like, we call that a clue. At that point, she should have went, you know what, this horse isn't ready. I'm pushing it. I'm going too fast. Let me get down. Let me walk it. Let me make sure he knows what I'm going to do. This horse is just super tense, super scared. This is what I call bad breaking. This is what I call, you know, just cowboying up or cowgirling up. You just get on, you ride it out. It's not good for the horse. It's not good for you. So this horse already faked once. I'll go back so you can see it again. There's that fake. I'm ready to run. She misses the clue. She doesn't have the reins. She's not in the saddle. She's coming off. The horse is gone. Yeah, she hangs on and she rides it off, and I don't know what happens, but not real good for the horse. So the guy kind of, what the hell happened here? Hey, video unavailable. Why is that? Did they take the video down? Oh, there it is. So the horse goes off to the North 40 and runs away.
Gonna kill herself on that crazy horse.
Yeah, it's a crazy horse. See, this is what the problem is with the horse world. This woman goes, she's gonna kill herself on that crazy horse. It's not the crazy horse. It's the crazy human that set the horse up to fail, that didn't control his head, that didn't make it so it couldn't run away, that got on it with loose reins so it had the ability to run away. Once it started running away, she couldn't stop it because she wasn't in the saddle. The horse gave her a clue that you shouldn't get on it, and she got on it anyway. This video is used under the Fair Use Act for educational and critique purposes, in case somebody whines. And there's another video that I wanted to do here on this horse right here. I always hear about how bad stallions are and how, you know, the only problem I got with this guy's bringing a horse out. He's smelling, the stallion's smelling, he's dropping. They've got the horse's tail tied up. They got the horse tied up. I'm not a fan of tying horses up. He's doing a Fleeman response right there. Fellman, Fleeman, whatever you want to call it. He's getting those. Now the guy's going to hit him with the rope and say, hey, hurry up. Just get on her and mount. Okay, this is kind of BS. The horse mounts. He breeds her. The guy stands there. Notice there's no chain on the horse. There's no bit. There's no long shank. There's no spikes on the horse's face. Everybody always tell me, you don't know stallions. They can be mean. You got to have a stud chain. You got to have this. You got to have... Look, that's all BS. If you handle a horse right, this guy walked this horse out on a halter, let him breed, and then he walks him back out to pasture and ends it. So this is good in some ways that they're showing, you know what, you don't need to do all this for the horse. He bred her. The horse stood there well. This horse obviously has done this before. The man's like, hurry up, get done. I mean, you know, damn horse can't even enjoy a little bit of loving with his woman here without some dude hitting him with a damn rope. So I got problems with what the guy's doing, but he's also doing some things right here. Takes the horse out. Walking him again, lead rope. He actually does have a chain, but it's not around the horse's neck. It's just hooked on there. That's probably stinking lead rope. But the horse isn't crazy. He's walking him out to a large pasture. The horse isn't pinned up in a dark area like the idiots now that have steads. Oh, you got to keep them pinned up. You got to keep them big. You got to have them walled, or they'll break out, or they'll run rampant and kill people. And I get so tired of hearing how bad and dangerous studs are when, you know what, it's just like everything else, just like the first video. The crazy horse is going to kill her. No, the crazy horse is going to kill her. The crazy human is making the horse crazy. And when you hear people talking about the crazy studs, they're crazy because of the people handling them. A horse is always a reflection of the person handling them, and it's not because of their breeding, because of the last trainer, because they were oxygen deprived, because you were using purple rope instead of pink rope, or whatever other excuse that idiots want to come up with. The horse does good when the person handling does good. When the horse does bad, it's because the person handling is doing bad. But a human can't look in the face and admit that they're wrong. Okay, to err is human. To blame the horse is even more human. All right, we'll end that there. Buddy, Miss T, you're good boys.